Hey guys, so for those of you who are already subscribed, you know I generally post animations. However, this video is related to art, so I figured it would be interesting to both artists and programmers alike. This tutorial was a project I created for both my programming class and a contest. The assignment was to learn an unfamiliar concept and create a video explaining it. As an artist, I decided to go with a drawing program. In this video, I will show you how to create an app that allows you to draw your own lines. Let's jump right into it. So once you have your main.storyboard open, you're going to go to the object library and pick out a UI image view. Now this image view should cover the whole screen, and this is what's going to keep track of and hold your drawing. Now open the assistant editor and connect your image view to the code. We're going to call this drawing image view since this is basically your canvas. Now we're going to create two simple variables. The first will be start point, and this will be equal to cgpoint.0. The default value is 0, but this will change later based on where you put your finger on the screen. This is going to be where the line starts. The other variable will be called swipe. This will indicate if the brush stroke is continuous or not. For now, it will equal false since we haven't done anything yet. This is the function that will be called when the user puts their finger down on the screen. Swipe will still equal false because we haven't swiped yet, and start point will move to the location where you put your finger down. This function draws lines. It is connecting the point you started with the point that you are currently drawing with. Now this guard portion here makes sure that the function can get the context. If it can, then it will and it will draw the line, but if it can't, then it won't. This is what prevents crashing. These lines of code connect between the starting point and the current point. They make lots of little tiny straight lines, but together they make one big smooth line. This makes sure that our line has a round tip to it. Now we're going to set the blend mode to normal because this is the default and we're only creating a very basic drawing app. I won't get into many other blend modes, but these are part of larger programs such as Photoshop. We could also set our line width to whatever we want, but I'll just go with 5 for now. We could also set our color to whatever we want, but again, since this is very default, I'll set it to black. These are all custom parameters. I am telling Swift that a line that the program draws should look like this. Now this is where we actually draw the path and the line is created. This line of code is telling the drawing image view to show our line as we are drawing it. Alpha is basically a fancy word for opacity or how transparent something is. Again, I am setting the default value, which is 1.0 or 100% opacity, which means that our drawing is going to be completely visible. This function is wrapping up our context to show up as an image view. In other words, this displays the line that you just drew. Swipe will now equal true because our touch has moved, and current point is going to be wherever our finger is on the screen. Now this may sound a bit confusing, but start point is going to equal current point. Because we are drawing, the touch is constantly moving. It is keeping track of where the touch is, which moves as you draw. The current point you are drawing is also equal to the area you are touching. Since start point and current point are moving with the finger, it creates a custom line that you are making. This last function is called when the user lifts their finger from the screen. If there is no swipe or motion, then the single touch will just make a dot. This chunk of code is telling the image view how to display your drawing. This can be different from how the line looks as you are drawing it, but for default purposes, we'll make the blend mode at normal and the opacity 100%. This saves your current line drawn so that the line doesn't disappear when you lift your finger off the screen. And now we're done. Just run your app and get to doodling.